Hello viewers, welcome to Jessie's Sweet Kitchen. In this channel, I will be teaching you how to make Italian and African dish with style. So please subscribe and share this video and give it a like and press the bell icon so that anytime I upload a video, you'll be first to be notified. So viewers, let's get started. In today's episode, I will be showing you how I make this my delicious lasagna. I will be taking you step by step how I make this lasagna. So come with me, let me show you how I make it. Okay, let's go to our ingredients. I have everything I need for my lasagna. Before you start, make sure you have everything that you need to cook. So I have my baked ham that I'll be using. This is optional. I have my parmesan. I have my little mozzarella. I have my canned tomatoes that I'll be blending with my long pepper. And my one habanero pepper, onions, tomatoes that I will be blending together. I have my grounded meat that I have. I have my aromatic herbs, my fresh rosemary, my bay leaf. In here, I have my chefs and thyme. I have my curry powder, my seasoning cube, my mixed spices, and some salt to taste. Here I have my onions and garlic and ginger, carrot. I have my celery. I have my pearl that I will blend it together for more flavor. So here I have my lasagna pasta. I have some wine that will give it extra flavor. I have my vegetable oil, my olive oil that I will be using, extra virgin. So first of all, I will be blending my carrots and my celery together with garlic and everything. So I will be blending my habanero pepper and my tomatoes in a separate food processor. So this is my blended ingredients that I have blended. So let's go to the gas. I will turn off my gas. Put my pot in the fire and add a little bit of olive oil. You can use any oil of your choice, but I prefer to use olive oil, give it more extra flavor. So after some seconds, add your blended carrots and ginger and garlic together and add your grounded meat and mix it very well. So allow it to cook like 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, give it a good stir. Then put your blended tomatoes and stir it very well and cover it. Allow it to cook for additional 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, give it a good stir. Add your seasoning cube and your aromatic herbs together and give it a good stir. Then after mixing your spices and your seasoning together with some salt to taste, cover it, stir it very well and cover it and allow it to cook for 1 hour in a low medium heat, very low. Allow it to cook for 1 hour, add your wine and allow it to cook for 1 hour. So after 1 hour, this is it guys. As you can see, my lasagna, sugo di lasagna is ready. So what I will do, I am going to do my bechamel. You had you put your pot in a fire, add your butter, allow it to melt. Then add a little bit of flour. You can use a cornstarch, but I prefer to use a all-purpose flour. Mix it together and add bit by bit, add your whole milk. Mix it very well, guys. This one needs a lot of process so that you will not have a seed inside. Continue mixing and add your milk little by little. But it's very difficult if you don't know how to do it. But you guys, you can use a wooden spoon or any spoon for this. Add your salt and a little bit of nutmeg. Continue stirring until it gets thicker. So you need a lot of effort, strength. So
continue stirring until you get it. As you can see, there is no seed in my bechamel, but when you do it, if there is seed, you can just sieve it with your fitter. But it's a long time that I've been doing it, so I'm perfect for it. So stay together until you get thicker. So our bechamel is ready. You can see. So what we will do, add your little bit of bechamel to your oven pan, add your lasagna pasta to it, then add a little bit of a bechamel and add your sugo di ragu to it, then add a little bit of parmesan and repeat the process and add your bechamel, your sugo di lasagna, that is ragu, add it together. But in the last part, I prefer to add two lasagna. I prefer to put two pasta di lasagna in together for more thicker. So I repeat the process. This time I put my baked ham. It's optional, you can put baked ham and mozzarella, you can skip that. So I put my parmesan before my mozzarella, but you can still put your mozzarella before your parmesan, but you can do either both ways. So as you can see, my lasagna is ready. Let's give it a taste. It's very delicious, guys. If you are in my kitchen, the aroma in my kitchen is very sweet. This lasagna is very delicious, guys. I assure you, when you make it this way, you will never buy a supermarket lasagna anymore. Let's give it a taste, guys. It's very delicious, guys. Subscribe to my YouTube channel and share this video, share it to your friends and family, and give it a like, turn on bell notification, so that anytime I upload a new video, you'll be first to be notified. Viewers, let's taste this lasagna. I can't wait to taste it. Guys, this is very delicious. I show you, when you make it this way, you will never think of buying a supermarket lasagna. It's very easy. It's not difficult to make. You can make it at home, because this is a channel that it will give you a little bit of twist. Guys, it's very delicious. You can see. Come and join me. Very delicious, guys. Very, very delicious. Give it a like. Give it a like, guys. And follow me in my other social media platform in the description box down below, guys. God bless you. God bless you very much. Thank you for watching. Thank you. Give it a like. And God bless you. See you next time. And bye-bye, guys. Bye-bye.